Well, welcome, Mother. Welcome to Andaz. I'm excited to get into the journey of your life and food. When you first started in this business, you actually put Indian food on the global map. What drove you to this journey?
Well, it wasn't exactly on my map at that time because I grew up in India, and in the house we had servants who cooked, and my mother supervised the servants. She didn't actually do the day-to-day cooking. And I grew up with food just miraculously appearing on the dining table, and I ate and was very happy and then went on to play or do whatever I was doing. So I didn't focus on the cooking part of it at all until I left India. And suddenly I was in cold Britain, and I was going to the Royal Academy of Dramatic Art, and the food there was in the canteen, which was on the fifth floor. And what did you find there but, you know, potatoes that had been cooked for about 3 hours, cabbage yeah. that had been cooked to till it was water, and then there'd be some see-through gray slice of roast beef. And I just would eat that food and think, dream about India and the Indian food that I'd grown up with. So I started writing letters to my mother, and I asked for specific dishes that are very Delhi dishes from my family. A potato dish which I loved, which is potatoes cooked with asafoetida and cumin seeds. And I wanted that recipe. So my mother wrote back on these flimsy air letters, three-line recipes. Take a little of this bitter and take a little of this of that bitter, put it all together. And I taught myself how to cook on the basis of these recipes. And suddenly, I mean, when I told my mother I'm writing cookbooks, she couldn't believe it. But here was a kid that left that knew absolutely nothing about writing cookbooks or food at all. And now she was the guru of the Western world.
Literally, my mom, when she first came to this country, actually bought your cookbook because she didn't know how to cook. And I grew up eating your food.
Well, I've met so many kids, and at least you are of Indian descent, but I've met very Western kids whose parents cooked my food, and now they are eating, cooking my food, and they're cooking it for their children, so it's gone into its third generation. It's really, I feel very, very gratified.
How did you know that food was going to be your life?
I never realized that. I don't think I've realized this to this day. What happened was that after England, I came to America, and I was looking for work as an actress. And if it's hard for Indian actors to find work today,
it was impossible
at that time. So I had to do something else because I was then married and had kids, and I had to provide part of the living and get my kids to school. So I started writing. I had done my BA in English, and I could read and write, certainly. So I was writing for magazines and newspapers, but I was writing about things I knew something about, and that was the arts. I was writing about painting and sculpture and dance, and I wrote one article on food. And that too, this just the food I grew up with in Delhi. Mm-hmm. And somehow that got me started, and I was suddenly in a world that I really knew very little about, but I was learning as I was going on, and I learnt on the run, as it were.
Do you have any cooking rituals that you can share with all of us?
Nothing like that. I have a glass of whiskey.
Yeah, see, there's your ritual.
That's my ritual. I calm down, I pour myself a whiskey, make a papar, have a little bit of that, then I'm ready to cook.
You're ready to cook.
Yes, yes.
So, Mother, do you have any troubleshooting or preparation tips for our viewers in the kitchen?
Troubleshoot is being prepared in advance. Because in Indian recipes, many spices go in rather quickly. Take everything down from the shelf, have it ready, and then start cooking. But be calm. Find your way to be calm and happy before you start. Because, you know, Indians in our whole Ayurvedic system, we believe that we pour our own hearts into our food, our love, our hearts. And then when we feed our family, we pass on that love.
So tell me, what is your favorite dish?
You know, as an everyday dish, for me, the most soothing food is for me is dal chawal, which is rice and split peas. Done the North Indian way with moong dal, I can live on that.
What advice do you have for our viewers that are searching for their passion in life?
Well, I think the thing is, find what makes you happy.
Yeah.
When somebody says to me, I can't wait to retire, I know they're not loving their jobs. I will do what I'm doing, which is acting and cooking and writing, until the end. I don't want to give it up. My joy in life comes from all these things. So when you find that, you will know that this is what I want to do for the rest of my days.
You just know.
It fills me. My cup is full when I do these. Every part of my mind and body is being used when I do this. I'm complete. Then that's it.
Then that's it. Thank you so much, Mother. It's been such a delight to talk with you and have you here on our show.
I'm Vaz, brought to you in part by Kingfisher Airlines.